8 out of 10 cats. Hello, campers. David Walliams. Who are you going to call? Yvette Fielding. And their team captain, John Locke. And facing them tonight, locate, relocate, it's Phil Spencer. The big mouth from the deep south, Reginald D Hunter. And their team captain, Jason Manford. Now, welcome your host, Jimmy Carr.
Hello, and welcome to 8 out of 10 Cats, a show about opinion polls, surveys, and statistics. Did you know, for example, if you stroke a cat 70 million times, you develop enough static electricity to light a 60-watt bulb? It also explains Susan Boyle's hair. 31% of taxi drivers don't take a break whilst at work. You'd think that would make them cranky and opinionated. And a teaspoon contains 120 drops of water. That's according to research by Professor, probably, from the University of... Yeah, I reckon. Let's get started. What are you talking about? That's the name of our first round. We've teamed up with a leading polling organisation and they've asked the British nation what stories they've been discussing this week. It's our panellists' job to guess the British public's top five most popular talking points. Jason's team, you're to guess first. What do you think people might have been talking about this week?
It's the untimely death of Molly Sugden. Who saw that coming?
Jimmy.
Is
it
Jimmy?
He had his choice.
Yes, David Watt.
Have you heard Michael Jackson is dead?
Yes. I heard.
People have been talking about it because he's a controversial figure. I mean, if it's wrong to share your bed with 13-year-old boys, then lock me up and throw away the key.
I just thought the coverage, like the night he died on Thursday, was Thursday when
yeah,
it happened?
Thursday, yeah.
I mean, I sat there all night just flipping channels between BBC, Sky News, just trying to see how many different ways you can say Michael Jackson is dead. There was this lady on BBC News, and she said, Michael Jackson, King of Pop, dead at 50. We go back live to Los Angeles for an update. He dead! He's still dead!
The saddest thing is about 10 minutes after his death, you get about 100 text messages from people you've not even seen them for 15 years. And you're like, who's sat there at 1:30 in the morning thinking, I've not seen Jason for 12 years, I might send him a gag about a dead celebrity 12 minutes ago.
People saying things like, he's entrusted his kids. Well, apparently they're not really his kids. Oh, he's not the biological father. Yeah. Which actually wasn't difficult to work out. They look like they're related to the Swedish royal family.
Do you know their names?
Prince Michael. One, two, and three.
No. What are your children called?
I'm not going to tell you the names of my children.
Why not?
I don't want you freaking them out as well. Poking your head over the fence going, hello.
Are you sad about it?
For me, it's a little bit like when Diana died. I couldn't give a fuck. The audience, how do you feel? Are you good? Do you feel sad? No, it's a weird one. A few of you, yes. Now, I read in the paper the big story, the real tragedy around Michael Jackson's death was the fact you were looking for a house and you lost out on the deposit.
there's an element of truth in that, yeah.
So did you find him a house?
He was actually found three houses. And this is perhaps why I'm a little bit of a conspiracy theorist.
Oh, yeah. Is he living in one?
Because...
Just a little bit.
He was due to sign a. He was due to choose one of the houses this week.
So what was he looking for? Was it a flat?
Fairground, isn't it? Has it got an ensuite? Has it got a waltzer?
Well, what was he looking for?
He needed what was essentially a stately home, but it needed to have all the mod cons of a gym and a cinema and a panic room and that sort of thing.
But I think what's quite interesting is they were going to have a state funeral. People could go and see his coffin. What they're going to do instead of a state funeral, they're just going to dangle him out of a window for 32 days.
Oh. Let's have a look and see whether Michael Jackson is one of the most talked about things this week. I imagine he's right up there. Yes, indeed. I think the highest percentage we've ever had. Yes, Michael Jackson has passed away. You could tell Michael Jackson wasn't well. He hasn't looked himself since about 1984. Jason, what else have the nation been talking about?
It's been hot. Really hot. Apart from in where I live, where it's not been.
I'm from Manchester, it's been hot. Where have you been?
Yeah, but you're in, like, cold places a lot of the time. Everything's hot to you. You know what I mean? You're like, oh, that was a cold spot. You're like, no, it doesn't. I just live in Manchester.
Oh, I'm getting something here. Any thoughts on the weather, Reg?
Yeah, it's hot. Probably ain't gonna be hot all that long. And if it stays as hot as it is, you're gonna have Spanish people coming over here to have sex. So...
Isn't there some government new system, an alert system?
There
to
is
warn
now
us
an official alert.
Yeah.
What a load of old rubbish. Yeah. Sorry.
As opposed to what you do.
I think the press could be more imaginative with where they cover the hot weather. They always have the same thing. They always have, like, some girls in a bikini near a beach, and then behind them they've, like, got a graphic of a sun with the temperature, say, 32 degrees, whatever. I suppose in about 40 years' time, that little sun will have 48 degrees on it, and on the beach it'll be full of dead people. Just lying there like that.
Let's have a look and see whether the hot weather is one of the most talked-about things this week. Yes, it's been really hot this week. The pavements in London were hot enough to fry an egg. Yeah, I'll have mine dog shit side up. Sean, what else have the nation been talking about this week?
The Queen wants more money. She said that she wants an increase in the civil list because she hasn't got enough money. And they've said no, they're not going to give her any more money.
What's the point in having a Queen if she got to ask somebody else for money? Surely, if you're the Queen, you go and you get the money yourself. Like, ah, look at this treasure chest of gold in the castle. I ain't got to ask nobody for nothing.
It's no good asking me. I don't understand it. She's on the money. All she's got to do is take a picture of herself and write £20 on it. It's done. That's money.
Or she could get sponsorship. She goes, hello, I'm the Queen, brought to you by PowerGen. Wearing a crown, because I'm worth it.
Can I ask, who's met the Queen? Who's actually met the Queen?
Me.
Well, everybody!
You've not met the Queen!
Yeah.
When?
We went to meet the Queen, went to Buckingham Palace, I had tea with the Queen.
Well, I'll ring her up later
well,
and
where
ask
did you
her.
Meet...
I have.
You have not met the Queen!
Every Tuesday, I give her trampolining lessons.
Cheeky-boo. Do you think sometimes, just to wind Prince Charles up, when he walks in, she pretends to be dead? That's when he walks in, he goes, yes! She goes, ah! Yeah, yeah!
Let's have a look and see whether the Queen's financial problems are one of the most talked about things this week.